All right, a shalom, shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, Bahashim, Raka Kodash. I just want to give double honors unto the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, who rule well, and peace and salutations unto the elect. I pray that this lesson is edifying unto the elect. And that is short, no, and to the point. Now, this lesson, I just wanted to go over the topic of having long hair. You know, also shaving your head bald and getting edge ups. Because you have a lot of men in Israel that know that, you know, Israelite men that know that they're Israelites, having long hair, dreads. They may get edge ups. Or, shave off, their head, shave their head with a razor, But the scriptures, say you shouldn't be doing that, man. That's not what the Heavenly Father commanded of us, In this truth, we should be following the laws to the best of our ability, It's very important, because that's how we show our faith. And getting long hair, getting edge ups and shaving your head bald, it shows that you have no faith, man. But I'm gonna give 1 Corinthians 11:14, to prove that, Israelite men shouldn't be getting dreads and long hair and shit, man. So this is 1 Corinthians 11:14. Doth not even nature itself teach you that a man that if a man have long hair, it is a shame unto him. So Apostle Paul is saying it's a shame for a man to have long hair, man. The long hair was given for a woman. Not for a man. That's if a man got a woman has long hair, that's woman like qualities, man. That man trying to be a woman. Flinging his hair all back and shit. Nah, man, that's some feminine shit, man. And me personally, I can't trust a nigga with dreads. That's me personally, man. But I'm gonna give verse 15. But if a man have long hair, it is a glory to her, for her hair is given her for a covering. So it's good for a woman to have her hair long hair, not for a man. Anyways, I'm gonna get another precept in Leviticus, to prove that you shouldn't be getting edge ups as a Hebrew Israelite, especially knowing that you're a Hebrew Israelite, man. This is Leviticus 19. Let's get to the 27th verse. Leviticus 19:27. Ye shall not round the corners of your heads, neither shall thou mar the corners of thy beard. And that's talking about getting an edge up, man. I'm going to get that word round. Get that meaning of the word round. Round the corners of your head. Right. To strike off. To strike off skin. To go around. Compass. Go around. So that's basically what you're doing. You're going around your head, edging it up. Cutting the hair around, your head. Or your, you cutting the hair around your head. Getting the edge up, basically, man. And it says, you shall not do it. Ye shall not do it. It's against the line. You also not supposed to edge up your beard either. Now, let's get another precept in Leviticus 21. And 5. Leviticus 21:5. They shall not make baldness upon their head, neither shall they shave off the corner of their beard, nor make any cuttings in their flesh. So you're not supposed to be making your shaving your head bald, cutting your head with a razor and shit, making it skin bald, man. That's going off. It's you pastors, Pastor Porkchop definitely liked to do that. He loved to do that, man. Wearing his suit and tie, tight as hell around his neck, looking like a damn gumball machine, man. But you're not supposed to be doing that, man. But neither that, I'm going to start up at the top. They shall not make baldness upon their head, neither shall they shave off the corner of their beards. Right, you're not supposed to shave off your beard. Nor make any cuttings in their flesh. And that's talking about, you know, tattoos and stuff. You're not supposed to be, because really what tattoos do, you put in a needle, and you, it's like a needle poking into your flesh, and you're cutting into your flesh. You know, you also have a thing called scarification. If you look it up, you know, men, they would cut themselves and make scars upon their, you know, chest or on their arms, wherever they, you know, scar themselves at. You know, you're not supposed to be doing that. You know, oh, you know a good example of that? You go in the movie Black Panther. His name was Killmonger. You know, he had a mark. You know, he had different scars on his chest and arms and stuff to show how many people that he's killed, man. So, yeah. That's an example of, you know, cutting to your flesh, man. You're not supposed to be doing that. Now, I'm going to get a precept to, you know, that Leviticus 21 and 5 because, you know, you have certain Israelite men that lose their hair. And you can't, you have no control over this, man. You know, but I'm going to get a precept in Leviticus 13. Leviticus 13 and 40. Right, so the man whose hair is falling off his head, he is bald, yet is he clean, you know? So if your hair fall off your head, you know, just, you know, regular balding, which when we get them perfect bodies, we're not going to be balding at all, you know? But, you know, we in these bodies, so, you know, these bodies are going to decay. And that's one of the things that happens, you know, certain men, they start balding. Balding at a certain age, but it's good, you know, because, you know, the Most High say you're still clean, though. It's good. Now, verse 41 says, and he that hath his hair fallen off from the part of his head toward his face, he is forehead bald, yet he is clean. You know, so you're still clean, man. If you you start balding, you know, on the top of your head, you know, you're still good, man. You know, so really you're not supposed to be getting a razor, you know, and shaving your head bald. But if it falls off, you know, naturally, well, I won't even want to say naturally because I'm just going to say, you know, if your hair fall off naturally, you know, balding, then it's good, you know. You know, so that was pretty much the video. I just wanted to, you know, make the point that if you got dreads, long hair, you know, if you shaving your head bald or you getting edge ups, either on your head or on your beard, you know, you going off, you going against the commandments of the Heavenly Father, man. And it ultimately shows that you have no faith because you can't even keep these simple, you know, these commandments, man. You can't even keep the commandments that you can keep, you know. The scriptures say, you know, offend less, you know, we're not going to keep the law perfectly, but there's certain laws in the scriptures that you can keep. Like, for example, this, you know, stop getting your edge up, bro. Show your faith to the Lord by walking in his path, hearkening unto his commandments, man. Show your faith, man, by following the laws to the best of your ability, man. You know, but that was it. No, I pray that this lesson was edifying unto the elect. And I just want to give all praises, honor, and glory unto Yahweh. Bahashim Yahushai Bahashim Rakakwadash. And I just want to give double honors unto the apostles and elders of Great Millstone who rule well in peace and salutation to the elect. Shalom.